Welcome back, students. In the continuation to the previous chapter, Unit 1, Functional English, today we will see the session 3, talking about change. In this session, you will learn how to talk about change. Read aloud and try to understand from the examples given below. Number 1, change for the better. Means to change so as to improve. Example, he does not watch junk movies anymore and it is a change for the better. He now enjoys serious cinema. So in this example, the work is done same. Earlier, he was busy or he was interesting to watch the junk movies, but now he has changed and now he is enjoying serious cinemas. So that is the change for the betterment. The work which he was doing was not that much good what he is doing now. So that is the change for better with example of watching a junk movie and serious cinema. Second change is change for the worse. Worse means going towards bad, doing not good things. The example is, she has started reading novels, but it is a change for the worse as she reads them more than her school books. So what she should have done? She should have read school books more, but she has started reading novels more. So that is the change towards worse. Next is change with the times, to accept and adapt to new developments. Our school is changing with the times. We now have computer labs with free internet connection. So as per the need, school has provided us a computer lab, and with the development, it has been provided with the internet connection. For a change, as something different. Why don't you wear a salwar suit for a change? You always wear sari. So that is to make change in your look. You will be looking different if you wear another dress. Next, time for a change. An expression used when it is time to make a change. So example is, I asked her if she wanted a cake for her birthday and she said, it's time for a change, let's have pizza instead. So here, what we do generally on the birthday celebrations, we cut cake, and now she is asking for a change that now we will have, instead of birthday cake, a pizza. So we discussed here some examples of change. And now we will see how we use active and passive voice. My dear students, in this chapter, very simple English is given. So we are not going to emphasize each and individual session given here. There are 22 sessions, so that will not go line by line, but we will discuss some important sessions. Now see, the active voice is, the hairstylist changed the color of my hair. So how will it be changed to the passive voice? The color of my hair was changed by the hairstyle. So what happens in the active voice? Whatever the subject is, that becomes the object, and in the passive, that object becomes the subject. So here the hairstylist is a subject, and in passive voice, that hairstylist becomes the object. And the object in active voice is color of my hair. So the object, the color of my hair, is now subject in the passive, and the word by is used to connect the object with the subject in passive voice. Another thing, the verb is in the first form in the active voice, and in the passive voice the verb changes into third form if the sentence is in the simple present tense. Next is, in passive voice, I was praised by the headmaster. So its active will be, in active voice this will be, the headmaster praised me. So the headmaster subject has become here the object, and praised me, so that me has become subject in the passive voice. So me has become I. In certain sentences in the passive voice, the subject may not be mentioned. As in these examples, subject is not mentioned. You should do the work should be done. We completed the marathon at last. The marathon was completed at last. So here, who has completed? Not given. The marathon was completed at last, but who completed is not mentioned. So the subject is not given. Same way, you can see this one also. Now we'll come to the exercise. Identify and click the sentence that are in active voice. Now in this exercise, you will tell which sentence is in active voice. The first one is, they have been scolded. I bought some clothes yesterday. The teacher is correcting the test papers. The test papers have been submitted. So here, number two, I bought some clothes yesterday is in active voice. And the teacher is correcting the test paper also is an active voice. And rest, they have been scolded and the test papers have been submitted is in the passive voice. Now we shall see the assessment. Select and tick the option that is in the passive voice. Number one, Ravi had to revise the document. Ravi had to be revised in the document, or the document had to be revised by Ravi. So the right answer is the document had to be revised by Ravi. Second is, Ram should learn how to adjust to change. So here, how to adjust to change must be learned by Ram. That is in the passive voice. Seema has changed the curtains of the bedroom. So here, the curtains of the bedroom have been changed by Seema. So this one is the passive voice. Can Nayan update this file? So can this file update Nayan? Or can this file be updated by Nayan? So here B is the right option. Can this file be updated by Nayan is in the passive voice. So now this session is over, and we'll see the next session, that is planning an outing. So we all are very good at planning for outing than doing any other work, isn't it? So here, an outing can be going for a picnic, going for a movie, going out for a lunch or dinner, or going out for shopping. All such outings require some preparations. The extent of the preparation may vary depending on the nature of the outing. So imagine that you have to plan a picnic for your family and friends. You may have to prepare a to-do list of all that you need to do and take to the picnic. What would you do to prepare for the picnic? Think. So in this session, we have just been taught that how we can plan before we go out, whatever the work. So here, how we will plan our outing, that is described. So making a suggestion for an outing. So if you suggest somebody, how will you say? Let's go for an outing. Let us go for a picnic. Let us go for the movie. Let us go out for lunch. Let us go shopping and have lunch outside. How about going for a movie? Shall we go for a picnic this Sunday? And how about a shopping trip and lunch afterwards? So here, everybody will say in a different way. So every individual is having his or her own way of planning. So these are some examples planned before going for an outing. And this is the way how you will ask your partners to go for outing. Planning the outing. I will book the cab and you can arrange for the food. So here we are planning. So one is going to book the cab and another will arrange for the food. So that is a plan, that such and such person will do certain duties. So for every planning, some duties are to be given to each individual, because that is where there is a team, a group work. So there the responsibilities are divided. So here the next one is, you can take care of the plates and glasses, bring bottle of water, napkins and some plastic bags. Can you bring two mats or an old bed cover to spread on the grass while they will have a game or lunch or whatsoever for just sitting? So that is also a work. So the work is given to bring the bed sheet. Next, can you check till what time the park is open? So one is going to see the schedule whether the park is opened or not. Suppose if the park is closed, so that is not a good plan. You have planned to go to the park and that day the park is closed. So that is also a duty to check the timing, whether the park is open and what are the timings of the park you can be in the park. Can you book the movie tickets? And if you are going for a movie also, so one has to book the tickets. So these are certain duties given to individual persons to arrange the things for a better planning of outing. Here we'll see the pronouns. So in this session you will learn how to make use of pronouns. You are all aware of noun, pronoun, everything. So we'll see once here. The reflexive pronouns discussed in this sessions are myself, ourselves, themselves, yourself, yourselves, himself, herself and itself. So what is a reflexive pronouns? Reflexive pronouns are used usually in three situations. So what are the situations where reflexive pronouns are used? So for example, I hurt myself. So here myself is a reflexive pronoun. The music group called themselves Dire Straits. So this themselves means denoting to the group itself, to themselves. So this themselves is a reflexive pronoun. He shot himself. Himself, he has harmed himself. So this himself word is a pronoun. What is a pronoun? The words which are used in place of a noun is called a pronoun. And the pronouns which denote to the subject itself, so that is the reflexive pronoun. So when the subject and objects are the same, he is also the subject, and himself is also the same person as object. So subject and object both are same. So in situation 2, you can see as the object of a preposition, when the subject and the object are the same. For example, now here what will happen? I bought a present for myself. So here I is subject and myself is a object. So again here I and myself is same. She did it by herself. So herself is a reflexive pronoun. That man is talking to himself. The man and himself is same. So these are the reflexive pronouns. And the next situation is when you want to emphasize the subject, when you are telling or putting a pressure on the subject, as I will do it myself. So here I is pressurized, I is emphasized that who will do this? I will do. Next is they ate all the food themselves. So who ate? They ate. So here they is emphasized. Now you can do this exercise by yourself. So yourself is a reflexive pronoun. The same way, dear children, now you will be able to do this assessment also. So please complete this assessment. Next session is narrating a story, session 5, and in the next class now we will see session 5, narrating a story, and session 6, describing a known place. So we'll conclude here and continue in the next class. Thank you.